Welcome to the Angular Dashboard Layout Component tutorial. The Syncfusion Angular Dashboard is a visual representation of multiple panels arranged on a single screen to monitor several metrics at a single glance. In this video, I will show you how to create an Angular app and add the Syncfusion Angular Dashboard component. I will also show how to add multiple panels and configure them in a structured layout and drag and resize the panels dynamically. As a first step, make sure you have installed the latest versions of Node.js and Angular. Then, I will edit my code using Visual Studio Code and finally view the output on the Chrome browser. To create a project in Angular, I open Visual Studio Code and install the Angular CLI using the command npm install -g at angular/cli command. Next, I will create a new Angular project. I use the ng new project name command and name my project my dashboard app. I am creating a project with the option to add a CSS style sheet, so I choose the CSS option. The project creation has started and an Angular project with its dependencies is being created. Now let me navigate to the project folder to add the Syncfusion Angular Dashboard Layout. Install the Syncfusion Angular Layouts package using the command npm install at syncfusion/ej2angularlayouts --save. The application is now ready to use. The first thing I must do here is register the trial license key to use Syncfusion components. I open the main TS file, then I import the register license method from the Syncfusion EJ2 base package. Using this method, I register the trial license key. To learn how to generate this license key, refer to the link in the description below. The application is now configured to use Syncfusion components. Next, open the app component TS file and import the dashboard layout all module from the Syncfusion Angular Layouts package and register it within the imports array of the component section. To apply styles to the dashboard component, navigate to the styles CSS file and add CSS references by importing the material theme. Now let's proceed to add the Angular dashboard layout component. I will open the app component HTML file and remove the default code snippets. Then I will add the Angular dashboard layout code. As you know, panels are the building blocks of the dashboard layout component. So I add panels to it by defining an object called panels. Within this object, I can add n number of panels. Now I am going to add only a single panel. Therefore, let me add a panel by setting the ID property to panel1. Then I assign this object value to the panel's property. Save the changes and run the application using the npm start command. Looking here, the dashboard layout is rendered with a single panel. Next, I will show you how to define a header and content for this panel. To add a title, I set the header property to panel1. To add the content, set the content property to content for panel1. See, now the panel is rendered with the header and content. Similarly, I am going to add 3 more panels to the dashboard. I copy the previous panel coding and paste it here. Then, I change the IDs, headers, and content for the newly added panels. To align the header and content, I open the style CSS file and override the base classes ePanelHeader and ePanelContent by setting text-align and margin-top styles to those classes. You can see that the dashboard has 4 panels with headers and content. By default, the panels are rendered one after the other vertically, with the last added panel displayed first. I have rendered the panels using the model property. Additionally, it is possible to render panels using 2 other methods, adding the panels using HTML elements and using an Angular directive with a template. In this demo, I will use the model property. Next, let's see how to position these panels in a defined layout structure using the columns property. This property will define the number of columns to be created in the dashboard. I would like to create three columns here. So I set the columns property in the dashboard layout component tag to 3. Then, I need to set the column position for each panel. For example, to render a panel in the first column, I need to set its column position value to 0 since they start from 0 in the dashboard layout component. For the second panel, I set the column value to 1. For the third panel, I set to 2. Since I've created only 3 columns, I need to place panel 4 in one of these columns. I will add the fourth panel to the second column by setting its value to 1. Now looking at the dashboard, panel 1 is rendered in the first column, panels 2 and 4 in the second, and panel 3 in the third. Like this, I can also set the row position of each panel. For example, to display panel 2 in the first row and panel 4 in the second row, I set the appropriate row value in panel 2. I add the row property and set its value to 0. In panel 4, I set the row value to 1. Like the columns, the row position also starts at 0. Looking at the dashboard now, panel 2 is displayed in the first row and panel 4 in the second row. Next, I will show you how to customize the width and height of the panels using the size X and size Y properties. The size X property is used to set the width, and size Y property is used to set the height in terms of the number of cells. I would like to increase the height of the panel 1 and width of the panel 4. So I add the size Y property in panel 1 and set its value to 2. Then I add the size X property to panel 4 and set its value to 2. You can see this in the dashboard layout. The size of those panels has changed accordingly. Next, I will show you how to reorder the panels using the drag and drop feature. I drag panel 1 and drop it over panel 2. Panel 1 will push aside panel 2 and replace it without disturbing the layout structure. To disable the drag and drop functionality, set the allow dragging property to false in the dashboard layout component tag. Now, when I try to drag panel 1, I cannot. Next, I will explain the resizing functionality. To enable resizing, set the allow resizing property to true. You can see the resizing handles for each panel. When I hover over it, it allows me to resize the panels dynamically. I can also restrict the resizing of panels within a particular region. Min size X and min size Y are the minimum height and width values, beyond which I cannot shrink the panel size. Similarly, max size X and max size Y are the maximum height and width values beyond which I cannot stretch the panel size. To demonstrate, I will restrict the resizing for panels 1 and 4. For panel 1, I set the min size Y to 1 and max size Y to 2. For panel 4, I set the min size X to 1 and max size X to 2. Looking at the dashboard, I can now resize the height of panel 1 only between sizes 1 and 2. It does not go smaller when I try to shrink it beyond size 1. I can only resize the width of panel 4 between sizes 1 and 2 as well. When I try to stretch it beyond size 2, it will not get bigger. In this video, I have shown you how to add a Syncfusion Angular Dashboard Layout component to an Angular application. You have seen how to configure the dashboard layout using columns, size X, and size Y properties, and interact with the dashboard panels by dragging and resizing them. If you would like to see a working example of this, you can download it from the GitHub link in the description below. Thank you for watching this video. If you found it helpful, please like it and subscribe to our channel.